Hey guys, so these are my thoughts on the whole Syria debacle, about Obama's administration's kind of way of responding to it, and how the whole situation has unfolded and whatnot. The disclaimer I have to give is that, well, honestly, I'm not really knowledgeable on this subject. These are just my thoughts, very basic thoughts, so I don't know if you can expect any insight out of this, but it is based on, like, you know, a bunch of stuff I watched, a bunch of articles I've read, articles from New York Times, Daily Beast, Slate, a bunch of different blogs I've watched, things of that nature. So, I guess that's just a disclaimer. I don't know where I'm gonna end up going with this whole topic, but it is a pretty hot topic in the country right now, and it has been for a good time, so I guess might as well jump onto the discussion. Honestly, the first thing I'll have to say about it is the way it has been going, and the way it is now, how the whole situation has ended up with this whole Syria debate. It's crazy. It's nonsensical and it's ridiculous. That's kind of like my first gut reaction to the story. One fundamental thing, I guess, that I have to ask, that I've always been asking, is why? What's the point? What's the point of bombing Syria? Or what's the point of limited strategic strike on Syria's defenses? So that's been the one thing that's been puzzling and irksome to me, asking that question, especially about Obama administration and some members of the Congress, and some people who oppose it. Like, their reasoning is also kind of bizarre, because a lot of the opposition comes from the Republicans, but, like, the reasoning they give is not, it's, you know, their conclusion I agree with, their reasoning I don't, you know. But that's the crux of the whole thing, you know. What's the point? What good would come out of bombing Syria? The rhetoric that the Obama administration uses is moral imperative, you know. It's morally important that we go and stop chemical weapons from being used again. So that's kind of the thing, which is I know this has been joked about a lot, but Syria has been under, you know, going through this entire disastrous bloody civil war for over 2 years now, which has resulted in lots of casualties and over 100,000 people dead, you know. It's something that Obama didn't want anything to do with. The United States had no involvement whatsoever for the past 2 years. And that's not because Obama is isolationist. That's not because the United States currently has a policy of isolationism. Because no, we bombed the hell out of Libya. We bombed the hell out of Kosovo. I forgot the name of the country. So, it's not really true. We're still having war in Afghanistan. We have all these military bases all across the world. So, the reason that we haven't bombed Syria is because there's no U.S. interest there. Simply, pretty much it. There's no oil fields there to take control of. There is some hypothesis I've seen that, you know, Obama wants to bomb Syria because we can build a pipeline in Syria that connects to Iran and Iraq, which would be highly profitable to United States business corporations, which is not too far-fetched. Except for the fact that in order to make that happen, this is a highly unrealistic scenario. In order to make that pipeline happen, what needs to happen is not just limited strategic strike on Syria, but pretty much invasion and occupation of Syria, just like invasion and occupation of Iraq. Except it's harder with Syria, because Syria has a much more highly sophisticated military technology than Iraq ever did. So, yeah. So that's that. So to me, this whole thing seems just like political rusing and political gaming. What seems to be on the line is just Obama's credibility, I guess? I don't know. Because Obama once said that, you know, if Syria ever uses the red line is, if Syria ever uses chemical weapon, that's the red line. That's when we have to intervene. He once said that. So to say we don't need to go to Syria now would make him look like a hypocrite and like an idiot, because that's what he said once before, and he would look like a flip-flopper. So in order to save face, I suppose, is why he is proposing to bomb Syria, or has been proposing to bomb Syria. And that kind of makes sense, except the horrible part of that is that's a horrible reason to bomb a country. That's a whole horrible reason to start a war, to save face of a politician. You know, to save the credibility of a politician is the reason we go to war. Horrible reason. And so there's all these like theorizing that, you know, Obama doesn't really want to go to war with Syria. This is just a political game. That's why he, you know, had he was about to decide to go into Syria, he backed out and then he asked Congress to decide. Well, that's because he doesn't want to bomb Syria, but because he wants to play this political chess game. And then, you know, he can blame wrong Congress if they deny it and whatnot. That whole thing was weird too, because, you know, now the president is saying, even if Congress says no, votes no on this limited strategic strike on Syria, even if so, the president still has authority to do so, which is just the political game. Like, then what's the point? I guess he wants to respect the Constitution, but if the Constitution is respected and it's not the outcome that he wants, he's still going to do it. So he's going to violate the Constitution anyway. Which is, this is why this whole thing was just ridiculously crazy and weird to me. Going back to the moral imperative that it's morally right that United States intervenes in a situation like this. That's the argument that really irks me as well, because, well, no, it's not up to the United States. It should not be acting like the police of the world, you know, be the judge of the world. That's what like the United Nations is for. And also, this is a civil war. Like, how do you determine which side to support when both sides are not the good guys and both sides are not, well, I guess they're kind of, it's a civil war. So picking a side, one or the other, is crazy. It's not a clearly defined thing like it was the case with Rwanda, which definitely needed intervention from the international community, but the international community did nothing for a long time, which is why there was a genocide. This is not a genocide, this is a civil war. This is like a civil war like Sudan, which of course, again, international community did nothing. I guess Middle East warrants attention, but Africa doesn't? I don't know. Another thing is, what does bombing Syria do? Nothing. That is actually morally wrong, because that just is killing more people. And the civilians are going to die too, so killing both sides. For what reason is the thing? To send a message for Syria to not use chemical weapons? Is that what bombing is going to do? And actually, no. That actually might worsen the thing. Because at this point, we're still not sure who used the chemical weapons. United States is saying there's evidence that it's you know, Assad? Bashar Assad, the Syrian government that used the chemical weapons. Russia is saying we have evidence that the rebels use chemical weapons. I, as a bystander, witnessing all this, I don't know who to believe in. All I know is that chemical weapons were used. There's this huge civil war. Chemical weapons killed about 1,400 people. The civil war, conventional weapons, have killed about 100,000 people on both sides. So there's this war going on, and certainly United States' plan is to intervene and drop bombs on a bunch of different facilities. And what does that do? That only means that, you know, Syria is going to be backed into a corner. It's only going to be like a huge international incident. And it's not like, you know, United States currently, if it does that, has the backing of other countries. Great Britain, for like the first time ever, says, no, we're not going to help you out. You know, we're not agreeing with you that we're going to attack Syria. They helped United States attack Iraq. This time they're saying no. There's no countries other than the United States willing to do this. So U.S. is going to go at it alone. And that only means Syria is going to be backed into a corner. And when you back someone into a country, into a corner, and when that someone has something like chemical weapons or nuclear weapons, what do you expect for that someone to do? To not use it? To give it up? To be like, okay, you attacked us, all right, fine, we get the message, fine, I'll step down, we'll do whatever you want us to do. No, they'll get more defensive, right? That's the rule of diplomacy. How did North Korea react when, you know, when Bush got all like, put North Korea into a corner? Did they cower out and be like, oh, we throw the white towel, we give up? No, they got even more rigorous in developing a nuclear weapon, and they eventually did. So, those are kind of my thoughts on the whole debacle thing. What is the solution? I don't know. All I know is the United States shouldn't go at it alone to bomb a country for no reason without like clear objectives, because what does that do? And the important question is why? Why would you pursue any course of action regarding Syria? And it really should not be just up to the United States. As Putin's most recent op-ed was saying, which is, I hate that it comes from Putin, because Putin is a hypocrite, because Putin led Russia into invading Georgia without UN sanction. And Putin is saying, like, United States attacking Syria without UN sanction is going to, like, make UN as pointless as League of Nations was back in, you know, World War One days. So hypocritical, although he makes a good point. This is definitely something that the international community should address, should be handled diplomatically as much as possible. But it's still a civil war. And that is something that the country itself needs to handle. And I think at this point, all we can kind of do is kind of watch along the sidelines and try to help as much as possible. But that's like, that's all we can do, really. To get involved into this quagmire of the civil war, it's a bad idea. And to do so, to save face of a politician, is a horrible, horrible, horrible reason. But those are just my two basic cents on the whole Syria debacle. Like I said, not too knowledgeable about the whole thing. These are just my basic thoughts. If you guys have any thoughts, any insights on this whole thing, and you're watching this, feel free to leave it in the comments. Thanks for watching. Cheers.